So every time you shower someplace new, it's like an adventure. But it's not a good adventure, okay? It's not like, oh, I'm moving to New York, woo! It's more like, I'm gonna try a new Indian restaurant. Could go either way. Because there's so many variables when it comes to a shower, right? Okay, when you go in, you're like, okay, what are we dealing with? Is it knobs, levers, taps? What's the pressure like? Is it hard? Is it soft? Is it one of those heads where it goes like a sprinkler? What's the temperature like? Is it sensitive? Is it too hot? Is it too cold? Will the water run out? What about the heat? Is the heating going to run out? Is it one of those showers where, like, if the water comes out from the bottom, you have to get it to come out from the top somehow? I mean, no one knows what it's called. You know, and I realized that showering a new place is a lot like getting with someone for the first time. So hear me out, okay? There's some disbelief, but trust me. Firstly, there are no instructions, okay? And it's too awkward to ask. Secondly, you come in, and you're the first thing you want to do is take your clothes off. But you can't. You can't, because you're not sure how it works yet. You're like, okay, I'm going to come in, let's see what I'm dealing with. Because you can't just start twisting knobs and pulling levers, okay? It's very dangerous. Someone could get hurt. And you can't just go in right away either. You kind of have to, like, stand back and be like, okay, what's going on? You start twisting some knobs, tapping some taps. Okay? And then once that's in, you can't just jump in. Okay, you go in from the front, it's too abrupt, it's too messy. You gotta feel it out with your hand first. You gotta go, okay. This thing's enjoyable. And then you come in, you don't go from the front again, you come in, you slide in from the back, right? And then when you're in it, when you're in the shower, you have to be vigilant. You have to make sure you know that you're paying attention. Because at any moment, the water can get too hot or too cold. And the response is always the same. Right? And they're like, oh, yeah, this is nice. This is nice. Oh, no. Oh. And then you got to fix it. You got to be like, okay. All right, I got it. And once you do get, hopefully you'll have a good experience at the end. But that's not always the case, right? Sometimes you'll have a bad experience and you'll be like, you know what? This is it. I'm just not going to shower here again. Other times, like, the shower could be so bad that you get angry at the shower. Not only that, you get angry at the people that made the shower. How could someone just screw this up so much? I took a shower once where the blue was hot and the red was cold. In what world is blue hot and red cold? Oh, our world, actually. That's the way physics works. I don't know if you know this, but like blue energy. Never mind, that's not the point, okay? I sure need a degree in thermodynamics to take a shower. And then every now and then, you'll take a shower that's so awful. It's just so bad. You question the very notion of showering. You think to yourself, you know what, maybe I should try baths. Seems to work for people. People like it. Maybe taking a bath is for me. But, you know, hopefully you'll find a shower that's right for you. You know what, this is it. This is my shower. I'm showering here every day for the rest of my life. Maybe twice a day if it's necessary. But you have to be careful when you're making that decision. You have to be careful because you may be doing it just because it's comfortable. You start taking longer showers than you should just because it's easy. It's easy not to get up. But you know you should. Your fingers start getting pruny. You realize you're wasting time and energy. And if you don't fix it fast enough, you'll realize that a clog develops, you know? All the little things you let slide has accumulated into a big mess. The next thing you're standing in a puddle of your own filth. And at that point, really the only solution is to take a bottle of toxic chemicals and pour it down the throat. I mean, brain. That's it for me. Thank you very much. Thank you.